I work on the LIGO experiment. That's an acronym for the Laser Interferometer Gravitational Wave Observatory. It's some of the largest pieces of scientific equipment in the world. It's 2 4-by-4-kilometer long laser interferometers. One is in inland Washington state. The other is about an hour outside Baton Rouge, Louisiana. And these sister sites operate in tandem, just passively listening to any distortions of space-time that might happen to propagate through the Earth as a gravitational wave. Gravitational waves are this new way to observe the universe. It's a completely relativistic phenomenon. It is predicted by the equations of general relativity. And in classical physics, you don't get any type of effect like this. Distortions in the fabric of space-time itself that propagate out like ripples in a pond at the speed of light. And just like electromagnetic waves, they carry energy and they carry momentum. And there is a lot of information about both these extreme astrophysical objects like black holes that create them, and about the physics of the underlying nature of space-time that they travel through to reach us. The instrument that we've developed here in my lab that we're disassembling today, these are enormous mirrors. They are 40 kilogram solid pieces of fused silica glass that are suspended from glass fibers inside an ultra-high vacuum system. They're extremely well isolated from the outside environment in all ways. My focus here at UCR is on developing new types of laser adaptive optical technology to overcome very fundamental physics limitations to how sensitive we can make these detectors. Across the vast majority of the gravitational wave signal frequencies that we can see from the ground, almost all of them are limited in sensitivity by quantum mechanics, by the quantum properties of the laser light itself. LIGO so far has seen about 200 events of stellar mass compact objects colliding and merging with each other. The overwhelming majority of those have been mergers of two black holes, but we've also seen mergers of neutron stars. The holy grail of this field is to go from the sensitivity level where LIGO is today, and my hope is that at some point we may detect some source that is completely unexpected, unpredicted. We see the universe literally in a new light that are not visible in others. And I hope the same is true for gravitational waves.